Hello, everyone. Imagine lying on the ground, away from the light pollution, watching the sky. The dimension of stars, beloved kilometers away, may seem as if they are not moving. If you look long enough, you will realize that they are actually in motion. The same is true for our planet. No, we are not talking about the world itself and its surrounding environment. We are proceeding from a movement that takes place kilometers below where we reach to watch the stars. From the core of the Earth. One of the most difficult points in the region where the details are under 6,378 kilometers under your feet. However, according to an article published recently, it has stopped returning internal benefits and may be redirecting in the opposite direction. Wow, this sounds like a big disaster news. What is the reason for the kernel to stop? Will we feel the effects of this situation? Let's look for answers to these questions together in this video. Xiaodong Song and Yi Yang from Beijing University tracked the movements of the inner core and analyzed the seismic waves from earthquakes in the last 60 years, claiming that the Pluto-sized inner core is no longer spinning in the same direction as the planet, but in the opposite direction. Since the inner core is close to impossible to investigate, most research on the inner core has been the subject of debate in the scientific community. Earth's inner core, which scientists describe as planet within a planet, was discovered in 1936 by Danish seismologist Inge Leifmann by examining seismographic data in New Zealand. The core, made of iron and nickel, has a diameter of 1220 kilometers and has a temperature of 6,000 degrees, which is almost equal to the temperature of the sun's surface. Due to the huge pressure exerted by the mantle and the Earth's crust on the core, the inner core is solid, but the pressure on the outer core surrounding the inner core is less, which is 20 to 60 kilometers thick, which is in the liquid state. At the heart of our planet is a war that has been going on for millions of years. Earth's magnetic field, produced by the rotating iron current in the outer core, pulls the inner core towards itself, causing the core to rotate, counteracting this strong pull by the descending gravity it exerts on the mantle layer, grasping the inner core and slowing its rotation. Scientists who believe that the inner core moves back and forth like a swing relative to the Earth's surface stated that this swing cycle changes direction every 70 years. In the mid-1990s, Xiaodong Song was one of the first scientists to suggest that the inner core could rotate at a different rate from the Earth's surface. Since then, seismologists have found evidence that the inner core's rotation can both speed up and slow down. The first evidence of this oscillation was recorded around Alaska in 1960, and scientists have been studying the change in seismic waves for decades with these data. Considering that it is 4 billion years old, it is useful to know that the activity in the center is not unique to our age. As with this new study, some unusual data were found in the early 1970s. The results show that the inner core rotated in a different direction between 1969 and 1971, and in a different direction between 1971 and 1970. So what? Won't there be scary earthquakes, huge tsunamis, or volcanic eruptions all over the world? The answer is no for now. The researchers reported that the rotation in question is in line with small changes in the time it takes for the Earth to rotate around its axis. The difficulty of investigating the inner core and the lack of available evidence have made scientists wary of the findings. So far, little evidence has been found that the inner core has any effect on the surface inhabitants. On the other hand, scientists state that they believe there is physical evidence between the layers of the Earth from the inner core to the surface. However, most modeling on this subject has not been able to fully explain what is happening in the inner core. We hope our study will encourage some researchers to build and test models that treat the entire Earth as an integrated dynamical system, said study authors Xiaodong Song and Ya Yang. Tunneling through the center of the Earth means overcoming the mind. Blowing pressure created by 6.6 sextillion tons of rock. This enormous pressure is 3 million times the pressure you would feel at sea level. If we were to open a 7.5 meters wide tunnel, we would have to drill 580 million cubic meters of rock with our imaginary SuperTech drilling machine. The deepest well, dug with the aim of reaching the deepest point we can go in the crust layer of the world, is the Kola Deep Drilling located on the Kola Peninsula near the Norwegian border of Russia. During the project, several side channels were opened from the main artery, and the deepest of these is the Sea Tree Trench with a depth of 12,262 meters. As of 2003, the drilling with a diameter of 214 millimeters at 8,578 meters was closed in 2005 due to lack of resources. Although it was active, it was abandoned in 2008, and the technical materials used were sold as scrap. While traveling to the center of the Earth is so difficult, scientists are working on many models of understanding the inner core. One of them, in a recently published study, is seismologist John Vitale from the University of California. This is a very careful study by scientists using a lot of data, but I think none of the models explain all the data very well, evaluated as, that's all for now. What do you think about this study? Do you think we will be able to descend into the heart of the world one day? What awaits us there when we can reach it? Please share your ideas with us. Don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell for more videos with this kind of content. See you later.